please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
It's results season, so let's get chatting with the management. We had Gujarat Alkalies and Chemicals that came out with a set of numbers. They looked quite good, though there was not much growth on the top line. The margins look splendid. So let's get chatting with the management. We have with us Mr. Prem Kumar Gera, the MD of the company, who joins us. Hi, sir. Thanks so much for joining in. Your margins, I remember them at around 80, 19%, 20%, 23%. Now they've moved up all the way to around 28%. Is this kind of a number sustainable for the rest of the fiscal?
Well, yes, it is. We have done very well in the first quarter when compared to the first quarter of the previous year. That is true. But whether sustainability and all, it all depends on the market conditions, which no one can guarantee in this, where our economies are completely open. You know, in such situation, no one can give any guarantees. But it is the company's performance, you know. There has been marginal growth in the production and there has been increase in net sales and we have controlled our operating costs very well, you know. So the profitability as a result has really gone up by 14.46% and profit after tax has also gone up and compared to last year. Whether it will be sustained, no one can say that. But our effort will be, yes, to produce at the one of the cheapest producers and peaceful labor. You know, as long as that sustains, we hope to give better results.
But Mr. Gera, particularly for Q1, if you could tell us what led to the margin improvement?
The major improvement came from reduction in our operating costs, which we could control operating costs considerably. Okay. And we could also improve our profitability because of our own managing cost of power. Very well.
Okay.
So those are the major issues which we are doing.
Is there scope to cut your operating costs further?
Not very easy because operating costs will also depend upon the power costs, which is a big input cost for us.
Well, Mr. Gera,
reduction will not be that easy.
Sure.
No, I don't think so.
Well, Mr. Gera, this time around, what your growth is very, very minimal on the top line. But I believe
you
have capacities that are coming on stream.
Yes.
With these capacities coming on stream, do you think, in fact, we can look at some top-line growth? Do you have any kind of a number in mind? If you could tell us, what is the current capacity utilization levels and where are you looking to take it to?
Well, we are already have more than 89% capacity. It's in fact 90% right now in our caustic.
Okay.
We're going on. And against the industry average of 82%. So we have been always there very high, but our de-bottlenecking in caustic will result additional production from that.
Okay.
And chloromethane de-bottlenecking will also give us more chloromethane from...
So in terms of revenue, sir, what will it look like? Will you see some... can we see maybe a 5-10% growth in terms of revenues?
We definitely see once these de-bottlenecking September end would be de-bottlenecking completion of chloromethane. So by December, we would be definitely having a September end, it will be completed. So the reflection will come in December end.
Okay.
And called chloromethane. And caustic is, again, by December only, we will be having new elements which we are putting up by replacing the old element, which are energy efficient and produce more. So we hope to control our operating cost as well as that by the new elements which are coming into place. So that's how it is.
Okay, so purely on the back of the increased capacity, only the capacity that you're adding, if you could tell us at 100% capacity, what could be the revenue addition?
I'm sorry, I don't have that number right now because I came out of some other...
Absolutely.
No problem.
Right. But we profitability has been on the move. We have the negative is that I have to negotiate wage revision.
Correct.
We must take it. Then we have kept a provision in the current numbers also about 8 crores already. So wage revision goes according to our numbers, then we will not have much problem. But yes, that is one thing.
Mr. Gera, I think hydrogen peroxide is around 10-12% of your business. Am I right?
Yes.
Okay, and there was some anti-dumping duty or some protection that was offered to you all. What's the sense over there? Is that helping you all? Are you all still seeing imports come in there? Will you all be able to increase prices? What's going on there?
We are already 105% on our rated capacity working on that. And the third hydrogen peroxide plant is
coming on
stream. Started.
Yeah.
Yes, but that will take about 18 months minimum to come on, and everything goes on well. This time the monsoon has created a little havoc in terms of, you know, flooding and all that. We had to stop our expansion for a month or so. But we hope we'll not miss the deadline. And but current, that will help us to sell very easily and make keep the revenue stream coming. Hydrogen peroxide profitability has been very well.
Okay, Mr. Gera, we'll leave it at that. Thanks so much for joining in. Gujarat Alkalies top line to be benefited in the future on the back of increased capacity, though scope to improve margins looks quite limited since operating costs, it's quite challenging to reduce the operating costs even further. By the way, for the markets, no respite on the frontline indices, so still down about 0.5%. It's the Bank Nifty where the sell-off continues. So now down close to about 325 points at the low point of the day. Today, remember, is also the weekly bank options expiry. So the last hour is going to be crucial. Stay with us for closing bell. And remember to keep sending us your stock queries on your stocks posted on our Money Control message board.